Hi everyone. In the last two lectures, we have seen how macros work. And what we want to do now is to learn how to create our own functions. We go to Tools and then we select the script editor. In the script editor, we can also create additional files on the left side. So these are the three macros that we already have. And I can also add a script here. And let's call this my custom function. Functions are very similar to how they work on any other language. And when we have one and two and we write equal to sum, this is a function. And like this, there are hundreds of different functions in Excel and in Google Sheets. But we want to create a function of our own. So we will start with a very simple example and then we will increase the complexity. So I type function and we want to give it a name. So let's call this multiply 100. Now this function is going to accept some parameter, which would be the user input, and we want to call that x. Then we open the curly bracket and press enter. The moment you do that, you notice that the line in which the function word is starting and the curly bracket is ending, it has to match. This tells me the scope or the block of this function. So we press tab and I will create a constant, and the constant would be the result, and the result is simply the parameter that the user is choosing, which is x multiplied by 100. The line has to end with a semicolon, so please make sure to do that. And now we want to return the result, so we return the result, and just like earlier, we want to close it with a semicolon. And we will save it. Let us go back. So if I've written, let's say 10 here, let me also increase the size. The function name that we had given was multiply 100, right? So we will say equal to multiply 100 and then select the input. And it tells you that it is 1000. Now you would notice that there is a red underline here, which means that it is an unknown function. Obviously, because this is a function that we have created on our own. Now this has a few issues in the sense that when I write multiply 100, it doesn't give me any prompt. And when I open a parenthesis, I can't see any of the arguments. For example, when we write VLOOKUP, we have all these arguments that come here. With some explanation, we don't get that in our own custom function. So we can add it, and I will explain it at the end of this lecture. Let us go back and create another function. So here we will say, in fact, I can just copy the same thing. I can say function factor 2. And this means that whatever value the user is choosing, it will get multiplied by itself, like this. So if the user is choosing 20, it will be 20 into 20. Let us save it. Come back. And if I say factor 2, you can see that it shows me 10 into 10, which is 100. Let me also write the formulas here using formula text. So you can see the functions as well. We can also have a function that will accept two inputs. So let's say function divide by x and let's say we have x and something else, so c. We will return the result as x divided by c. Save it. And this time we can come back and we can have 120 here, and we can say equal to, the name is divide by x. So we write equal to divide by x, and we will take 100 comma 200, and it tells me the result is 5. All right. Now the last example that we want to look at is going to be slightly more complicated, not in the way the function works, but we have to provide it additional inputs as well. Let us see how we do this. First, let's set up the problem statement. So I have my old value, and we also have our new value. So let's say it is 100 and 110. And we want to see the percentage change, which is nothing but 110 minus 100 divided by 100, which is a 10% growth. Right. So first, let me make a multi-line comment that we do like this. And we want to create a function to calculate the percentage change. And for this, we will write at param for parameter. Then in curly bracket, we have to say that it's a number. And let's just call this old val, which is the original value. We'll copy this. Then we have the new val, which is the new value. And then we want to return the So we have the percent change from old value to the new value. And let's just make sure that everything is aligning properly. Perfect. Now we say at custom function, and we have already closed the comment. So function percent change, we have the old val and the new val, which are the inputs. And the result is very simple. Like I said, it is nothing but the new val minus my old val divided by my old val, like this. So that completes our function, and we also have created these parameters, and you will see how it works. So we are essentially telling that there is a custom function, and now when we go back and I say that we want to find out the percent change, you will notice that all the other functions have this one line explanation, and we also have the same for percent change. It tells me create a function to calculate the percent change. Let me also change the spelling here, just a moment. All right. So we have percent change. Let me also save it. So we have that one line explanation, and then when we open the parentheses, you notice that just like any other function, it tells me the two inputs, old val, new val, right? And I can also see the about, which tells me that we want to create a function to calculate the percentage change. So this is extremely handy because the example is telling me what type of inputs I have to take, and it tells me old val and new val is what I have to input. So in this lecture, we have seen how we can create a function. So we created three different functions, very simple. Then we also created a function which had two inputs in it, which was this one. And then finally, we created a custom function, which makes the function look like a regular function that you have on Google Sheets.